No TV and journalists were allowed to access the scene. After some time, ambulances arrived at the factory's main gate, and before entering, they were thoroughly checked by security. It took some time before the ambulances could come out, but after a while, they came out and sped off escorted by a police patrol vehicle. One of the casualties was found in deep pain in Jinja Hospital waiting to receive treatment. The deceased was identified as Sandra Boni, a 25-year-old resident of Njero. Jennifer Alitiri, the stepmother to the deceased, who was inconsolable, revealed that the deceased was working as a port in the factory. Alitiri explained that the deceased had just started working in the factory. She condemned police and factory administration for taking a relative's body to Jinja mortuary before informing the family.
Genda kulaba mama yagenda kunyire neye mirimo koma bakambe mwana afude ali ayukanati litugende tusanga bamaze kuleta wa obade dani wano nikumanga manganze silaba kati ndabo ono tuingira tulaba saje no simani bichokola.
The Sezibwa Region Police publicist Helen Bototo explained that the deceased was demolishing a certain wall in the factory premises, which later collapsed and killed him on the spot.
Yes, today in Njeru, at here, at night here, I registered an industrial accident where one, Boni Sande, 25 years old and a Rugbal by tribe, resident of UEB in Njeru Municipality, Wiki District, he was trying to demolish an old building, and one of the sites is called the sand filtering site. Unfortunately, the wall collapsed and it fell on him. He got serious injuries. His friends tried to rescue him. It's unfortunate that he passed on. So police was informed and we rushed to the scene. His body has been taken to Jinja mortuary for postmortem as investigations are ongoing.
Bototo confirmed that only one person had been killed, while the other victim had been taken to hospital for treatment.
Also the parent to Boni Sande, on hearing such information, he collapsed, and later on, immediately, he was also rushed to the hospital for treatment. However, as police, we are still carrying on the investigations to see what exactly happened.
By press time, the factory management had not commented on the accident. Story by Emmanuel Balukusa for the news.